Hey guys, Tatsu99 here, and we are going to see today the Ascension of Legends, and I have a special guest today who just made this tournament, and everyone should thanks for him for it. It's Uraxor. Hi Uraxor, how you doing?
Hey.
And I guess the games will start in 3 minutes, right?
Yeah.
Okay, and we have a finalist like Zavalos, the Aggressor, Power, E-Viper, Lurifax, Red Pepper, Masparov, and BR Soul Power. All of them very well known players, all of them very, very strong players. How do you feel about the finals, Uraxor?
Oh, I don't know, I'm really curious to see how it works out, because, you know, you've been part of it, it was 5 weeks, and you had to get games done every week, you had to submit, you had to submit bands, you had to think about it a lot, so, it was a long way.
Yeah, it's good to see a big tournament in DOC, and I hope you just don't stop it here, you will... I hope you just will make more and more tournaments, because it's really cool and it's really helping the community. How do you feel it?
That's a tough question. Well, now we will be transitioning into a new studio, so after that we will see what happens, how's it going. If they are willing to put more effort into the game, then I will be happy to keep organizing tournaments, I guess.
Yeah, we will see that. How do you feel about this big change? Blue Byte will take care about DOC. How do you see? How do you feel? How it will work? It will be better or?
To be honest, I haven't played any games from them, I think, because I've been playing just Duel of Champions for the last 2 years, but I really hope that a fresh blood will help to get things going, and I'm really curious to see where the game goes from here, because I don't want it to die.
Okay, and about the tournament, have you anyone of your favorite player here? What do you think, who will just reach the final, who has the most chance?
Oh man, I have no idea. All the players have gone such a long way, so it's anybody's game now, and I feel like all of them have chances to advance. There will be 3 players advancing into tomorrow's last day of the competition, and people will have a chance to predict which of them will become the legend, and from the people with correct predictions, we will draw one winner who will walk away with a Sins of Betrayal box, entire box as a reward, so it's really well worth following.
Yes, exactly. Okay, I also don't know, the names are big, the competition should be good, every game will be BO3, no bans at this time, not like in group stage. So, I guess we will see a lot of Inferno here. So, you know, you have contacts with the players. How are they doing? They should start in the near future, right? And we will start with Zagrasher versus Zabaloo game, I guess. I will just see it if they are starting, and then we will join to the game.
Yeah.
Okay, until that, guys, I wanna say keep your eyes on the chat, because I will share some shows some Sins of Betrayal super pack, as always. I still have some. So giveaways will go on, of course, and you should rewatch the games in Hectoring YouTube channel. If I'm right, am I right, Uraxor? Hectoring and Azza will cast it also later on YouTube. And if I'm seeing right, Zagrasher's game just starting, so we just can jump to it. And this is the first game between Zagrasher and Zavalu. The first turn. Zagrasher playing Cat on the right. And Zavalu playing Cassandra on the left. He is starting with revised tactics. This is not Inferno. My expectation wasn't good. So, the hands. Let's see how the hands are looking. Zagrasher has a Goblin Scat for first drop. That's... Or maybe he can play Dragon Crystal and Bloodclaw Shaman. But if he going to play that, maybe he hasn't any cast to play next turn. Construction, interest, really. Zavalu's deck is really interesting. Look at this construction and lots of stacking. I feel some barracks also. How do you think, Uraxor? You are already in the game spectating?
Or no, actually, I'm trying to get in. This game on me, so I have to use a spectator mode.
Okay.
So I will be with you in just a few minutes.
So Zavalu just use construction to search for barracks. And start the stacking here. Zagrasher has a broken bridge, but I don't think he will use it now. It's just not worth it. Going to play Goblin's Cat. And this is the problem with the previous turn Dragon Crystal. As I said, he just can't play anything here at the third turn. Except the Goblin's Cat. Oh, I don't know. Or maybe he could play War Tent. That was another option, but mostly with Stronghold you always wanna play War Tent on the front line. I think because of Shredders. That's just a very good value. And Zavalu start with another construction and another Wolf Trainer. He has already two Bracks on the field, two Wolf Trainer and this two stacking creature with two stacks. Nice. And I guess the Zagrasher is in a little trouble. He can play Blastsnake Shaman here, but that's always dangerous to play Blastsnake Shaman in front of creatures because you don't want to let him die. So what he can play? The bridge is still not worth it. It will be much better later when he really need to deal with the stacking creatures. I guess he hasn't. Maybe the storm rage gonna be good to kill everything here, and the Goblin Scat then can go there. That's an option. But he didn't choose that. He played the Bloodsnake Shaman front of the Wolf Trainer. Now stacks coming. Lots of stacks. I guess. Zavalos deck is really interesting. I have to say that. I like it. And he already dealt 9 damage. That's a huge lead here. And the aggressor just forced to play Broken Bridge in the next turn, I guess. But where he can play, maybe there, but then I don't know, the aggressor is in trouble.
Yeah.
Okay, and Zagrasha have to play Broken Bridge. I guess that's the only choice. He knows there is another Griffin Crossbowman in Zavalu's hand. Hard. I have to say it's hard. Maybe he can play War Tent? No, of course, Broken Bridge coming. Oh, this stacking deck. I guess Zavalu got a really good hand with two construction. He just could play really early barracks. And he has the crossbowman, which is awesome to stack with stackable creatures with barracks. And the game may be already decided, but who knows? That stack on the barrack wheel can deal a lot of damage here, I'm sure. Olifant coming, just blocking, but it's already 5 more damage and 7 with the, no, it's just 6 with the event. It's just 6, but it's already looking very good for Zavalu. Maybe he can play the Fury Sunrise, but it's not really important because between 1 and 2 HP is there isn't too much difference, so I think he just choose the better way and keep the pressure on. Dumbram coming and Zagrasher just gave up. That was the first game between these two players, so it's already 1-0 for Zavalu.
Okay, can you hear me now?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Cool. For whatever reason, it wouldn't allow me to spectate them, and so I have to get my spectator mode working. which might take a while because I seem to be having some troubles with it. So that is probably up to you.
Okay. So we are waiting for the second game and some technical problem in Uraxor's side, but I hope I can handle it.
Yeah, I'm sure you can.
So Uraxor, what I want to ask here, what do you think? Did you see that stacking Cassandra already in standard? It's with construction, with barracks, with lots of fortune card and everything. Did you see? Yeah, construction.
Construction is the one that lets you search your deck and play a card for free.
Play a building for free. Yes.
Building, yeah. Well, it adds a lot more stability to the deck, doesn't it? So then you can, then you're more likely to get your buildings on which it's all based. Yeah, but I haven't played much recently. So, but I know in open, Siegfried with buildings is super strong. So it's something similar, it's still gonna be strong. Have you played it?
I didn't see that Cassandra, but Zavalu just played here. I didn't see never ever. And the second game is starting, so I will stop it here. And this is the second game. Now Zagrasha still playing Cat, while Zavalu playing Togruul. It's interesting, there wasn't any ban. So players,
there are no bans.
Player can play what they want in standard. They can play anything. And they are choosing interesting decks. I like it, I really like it. So Zavalu playing Togruul now. It's a fire or spell damage hero. With almost unuseful ability, but it's useful ability sometimes, but not really good. The biggest weakness of Zavalo's deck is Power Rains, and looks like Zagrasha just knows it. He is doing it with defending, and that can be cause some trouble for Zavalu. What just Zagrasha forget here? The Dragon Crystal, maybe. Because with Dragon Crystal, Zavalu easily can kill the Stormreach Hunter and can get some advantage here. Let's see, also he has 4th Firebolt. Let's see. He is up the magic. Maybe 4th Firebolt coming, but I don't like 4th Firebolt. I like to play Bloodcrow Shaman somewhere and Dragon Crystal on here and kill that Stormreach Hunter. I think that's better move. Oh, but he's not doing that. Interesting. I don't know why not. There is a week of mercenaries that can kill that Batko Shaman and maybe some sacrifice. I don't know. Okay, that's maybe not good. The week of mercenaries here. But still, he can play something like a War Elephant here and attack. It's safe. At least looks safe for me.
Okay, back.
Yes, you are here. Welcome
good,
back.
Good. Oh man, this is such a nightmare. How's the game looking?
The game looking like standard. I mean, there is just some creatures drop down. Now the player's gonna deal some damage.
Mm. Why do you think they wouldn't go for Inferno? Do you think they are too scared, or do you think they're trying to outpick their opponent?
I don't know. I still think Inferno, of course, the strongest, and I guess everyone here wanna win the games, so they should play their best decks. But looks like they are just doing some show for us.
Maybe, or maybe it's just the mind games, same as it was in Paris a few weeks ago. Picks and counter picks.
Yep. So Zergasha playing Bloodsnake Shaman before he is killing the Bloodclaw Shaman. That means he will also kill the Goblin's Cat with the Bloodsnake Shaman ability. And just almost cleared the board. Save a lot of counters. That was a really nice turn for Zergasha. Yes. Fourth firebolt coming. Double fourth firebolt coming looks like. Nope. Maybe I should play double fourth firebolt here. I don't know why was that bad. Maybe he wanted to keep some more creatures, more pressure on the board. I don't know. Zagrasha doing 6 damage here, and still he has a very good hand. With 2 Olyphant he just can't block anything here. And also Bloodclaw Shaman. That's a lot of blocker for Zagrasha in hand. Should be enough. Also, he has 2 insect swarm. If something went wrong, he still can come back to the game. So I really like Zagrasha's position here. I would take it instead of Zavalos. But we will see. Zavalos still has a lot of chance here. The game not decided yet. He can play Bloodclaw Shaman, of course. Somewhere. He is playing it aggressive. That's interesting. Okay. Well, a problem here, maybe the insect swarm can hit easily. And can deal like 2, 4, 6 damage and clear the board, and the last 6 damage easily finishable with shredders or something. Maybe that's not the best play. And maybe this is better, yep. But Insect Swarm still can come. So he can deal 3. He will kill this. That's 4. That's 7 damage if he want. And I guess that's a really good play here. He should just go up to the... go up for the Insect Swarm. and after that he will keep all of his creatures on the board. He decided to not to do that. That's a little bit more defensive, or I don't know how to call it. But okay, Zavalu drew a Zephyr Wind Chaser here. That looks a good draw, but still not saves the day for Zavalu. He still need to open one line at least, and there is still two Insect Swarm and Shredder coming. Interesting. So, how are you doing, Uraxor? Can't you get work the spectator board?
No, I can't get it to work. I will have to look into it for tomorrow.
Okay. What Zavalo have to play this harpy, of course, but he is thinking where he should play it. I guess there is a little bit better, but I know. But of course, I know the aggressor's hand. There is two insect swarm. He must play it here. Yep, and he played there. Looks like he is also seeing the aggressor's hand, or just knows that can come. More likely. Okay, Zagrasha can deal 2 damage. And maybe he can deal more. If he just attack, insect swarm, and play the Shredder. Not looks good, I agree, okay. But looks like Insect Swarm will come anyway. Nope, still not. Then he should draw first if he wanna draw, because maybe that was a win. With the sacrificial altar, he just should sacrifice this for Zephyria, and he got a lot of damage there. And this still looking very good for the aggressor. Poor Zavalu just didn't get any spells. That's his biggest problem. No insect swarm, no win. He got some fourth firebolt, but fourth firebolt against Stronghold is not too strong, because 2 damage against the big fatigue creatures is not really worth it. He still can play it, of course, and kill the Shredder with Shredder. Or kill the Blastcrow Shaman, looks like. Okay. Well,
can we have like results coming if you're interested?
Say it again, please.
BR Soul Power won against Mars Sparrow 2-0.
Okay, so BR Soul Power already in the semi-final. Is that a semi-final? Is that round 2, I know? No, it's not a semi-final, it's a quarter-final, right? Yeah, so BR Soul Power won 2-0 against Masparov. And looks like Zagrasha will make this game. So it will be 1-1, I guess.
I will try to find out at least which decks they played, yeah.
Zavalu still in trouble. He still can block all the line. He can play 2 Freakos creature and the Stormreach Hunter. But still it's very hard to say he can come back to the game, especially with Golden Horseshoe. That was a really good top deck for Zagrasher. He will use it for sure. Or maybe he don't really need it. Okay, he decided to use it. He even can play like coming the Shredder here, kill the Harpy and Broken Bridge it back, replay it, and that's already more true damage. But he can play what he wants, in fact, he is in very good position. And Wartant will be the next card. In the next turn only, of course. Broken Bridge here, not really good, I guess. He need to kill this Harpy with the Shredder for sure. That's obvious, I guess. And maybe just deploy and pass and turn and next turn somehow try to win with Insect Swarm. That's gonna be my plan here in his position. But he decided, looks like, to play now Insect Swarm, which is also a very good move, of course, just reducing the cards in Zavalu's board. And he has card advantage, so Zavalu is got a hard time to defending. He need to move the Oliphant here, I guess. But the problem is this power lane. This power lane is very strong. As I said in the beginning of this match, power lanes against Togruul is very strong. Togruul just hasn't broken bridge. Only Fire Rain, the only card which can deal damage in a row. And after Blasting Shaman nerf, even Blasting Shaman can't help. That was a nice play, but there is the Wartant. He still can clear this lane and make it even stronger with Wartant. And Wartant on the Harpy, or maybe I should play on the Goblin's Cat. Of course, first need to play this. I should play in the Goblin's Cat because of Shredder. And he don't really wanna lose that Wartant. Maybe even better to play Wartant on here to kill that Kentaur Archer, or here and kill that. I don't know, we will see how he decide. There is tons of play for him. It looks like he decided to kill the Centaur. Broken Umbridge here is not good. He just don't really need it. That's the trust. He just giving back the card to the hand, and Sevalo has enough resource to play again everything almost. So I don't really like the broken bridge there. Blocking with Stormbridge Hunter or something like that should be better in my opinion. But maybe that's why I'm not in the finals.
Okay, can you hear me now?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Awesome, I've managed to get into game. I'm watching E-Viper against Pavel, and it's Damiria against Ignatius.
Ah, nice. This game will end in like 2 minutes, so we can jump to there. Also, or you can try to join for the next Aggression Zavalu game. I don't know if you can.
Yeah.
Because
maybe I can just keep watching this one and
yeah, I guess that's the best.
Tell you what's happening there.
And another Wartend in Zagashor's hand. He can kill. Maybe he need to kill the Shredder, I guess, and just move away with the Harpy. Yeah, he doing that much better than my first talk. I would keep these counters and just move away with the Harpy, but looks like he is killing the Oliphant. Still good. And next turn, I guess. Oh, Insect Swarm, another one? No, it's just a Firebolt, but Zagrashtar just played a Pass of Ancestor on the Blast Snake Shaman, and that's why Zavalo just can't play for Firebolt there and can't kill. And that should be the end in the next turn. That should be the end.
It's funny because E-Viper is playing the Damiria with greater fire elementals, the Hectoring Plate in the finals.
Nice. Okay,
yeah,
and
Pavel is playing. Yeah, go for it.
And this game looks like ending with the Zephyr Witches are coming, just targeting the Bloodsnake Shaman, and that should be enough for Zagrashar. Make it 1-1. So, can you join for the next game, Uraxor? If they will start.
Yeah, I can.
Oh, this will be the final between these two player in the BO3. And we're just waiting until they are start it. So what about that E-Viper match? Both of them played Damiria with fire elementals. Hector encountered Damiria fire elementals with fire elementals. Are you here, Uraxor? Okay, looks like we lost Uraxor here. But the game is still not started, so we have to wait. I will take care of chat now. And as I said, guys, just keep your eyes on the chat, because I will release some giveaway. And because there is 10 minutes delay, I can't say it in real time. Every giveaway need to follow my channel, of course. And if someone win, he will get a Twitch message with the Sins of Betrayal super pack code. And the game still not started yet. Okay, while we waiting, let's check the finals. Beelzebub were already in the round 2. But Masparov still has a chance because there is a loser bracket. So everyone will can win still if he just lose in the round 1 or 2 on in the semifinals. And I will just share the bracket on the chat. And they are just starting the game, Zagrasher and Zevalu again. This is the third game, the standings is 1-1. Zevalu playing Kalazar, he is going to take it serious now. Zagrasher keep playing Cat. He is committing with Cat. Let's see. Zebalu's hand looks good. There is Alone in the Dark, there is Arcatrat, and there is Time Jump. Also, he can play Osmotic Breeder if he want. Looks really nice for him. But Zagrasher with 2 campfire just trying to take the board lead. And he going to be offensive in this game. Zevalu wanna be sure he just keep alive his creatures, moving the Hatching Breeder front of the Blasco Shaman, so it can't kill it, at least not now. Zagrasher playing it very clever. He is not allowed to play Zevalu Alone in the Dark. He is playing around that, he making some power lane. But power lane against Kalazar is not that good because of bloaters. But still, Zevalu can play some. Oh, he can't. Okay, he is going to kill the Oliphant here. But with this play, he only can play a bloater now. He hasn't free magic, he hasn't anything. And Zagrashar in this turn can deal a huge amount of damage with the Blastning Shaman. If he just attack with the Rana Harpy, that's already plus 2, plus he can attack with the Blastcrow Shaman, that's plus 3 already for Blastcrow Shaman, so it's 6 damage in this turn if he want, but looks like he don't want. I wonder. I should sacrifice that Harpy for that 6 damage. Now Zavalu can play the HQ, the unique fire creature, which is really good for him because he can kill the Blastning Shaman there. Also, he can kill if he wants the Rana Harpy, if he plays the Hikiyud here.
This seems to be a Zergrasher's game now. Like Sevalu has the time jump, but Zergrasher has the board. He needs to get Arkad's Wrath soon to turn it around.
He has Arkad Wrath in the graveyard, so he is just waiting for a Spell Stealer Heretic here to get that.
Or that. Zergrash is trying to push as much damage through as he can before Zevalu draws the Spell Stealer.
Yes, that's why I said he should deal that 6 damage and sacrifice the Harpy in previous turn. I don't know if you saw that already. But that should be a good play in my opinion. I don't know, he just didn't choose it.
Now
he can play a Damran or maybe the Shredder and Phoenix. He choose the Damran.
And 999k won against E-Viper, so it was 2-0 as well. It means that he won with Ignatius against the Damiria, which is not much of a surprise, I would say.
Yeah, I agree. And Power 999k will be the enemy of this match winner.
Yes.
Here Zavalu can deal even 7 damage if he want, but then he will just get a lots of damage. I don't know what is good for him here.
Maybe he should just move everything up into the power line just to block it and hope for board clear as soon as possible.
Yeah, but it still will be 7 damage. That breeder is always trolling.
Yeah, that was a lucky one. But yeah, he's played the Forked Firebolts well because he's preparing for the Arkad's Wrath, and he's also trying to prevent Zergrasher from being able to play like double Insect Swarm with Damran surviving. So there's a little plays that help in few turns.
Yeah, exactly. But here, which side you would take here? I don't know, because Zavalu has time jump, and I know he just need to get Arcatwat or Spellstealer Heretic here to come back to the game. But Zergrasher has a very good pressure on the board. What do you think?
Yeah, I think that depends on if he is able to draw.
Okay, so you think?
Yes. Yeah, for now, sure.
That was a nice move. Ariana banished the Moon Phoenix. But of course, it's just not looking enough at the moment. Oh, and there is another nice roll, the Fury of Windchaser. That can be some more damage for the Rusher.
And he has Shredder to come after that as well.
Yep.
It's a lot of attacks around.
Looks like Zergrasher decided to... Maybe he will just play Blastnik Shaman and run a Harpy. Or he drew now.
And then he has another Zephyria coming.
Yeah. He gutting units. Oh! I didn't expect that he just targeted the Runner Harpy instead of the Blasco Shaman. That's minus one damage, but... But he could attack the arena without retaliation. I guess that was a good move. And he is defending Zephyria very nicely with Pass of Ancestor and also with two adjacent creatures. So no Elven in the Dark, no Sewer River. Not even Arcatrat's helping here.
Yeah. And he is not getting a card he needs the value, so it's not really looking for him.
Yep. Was Multi Breeder coming? I guess on the bottom row. Yep. He just went to defend. Yeah. And killing the Dumb Run. Also using the ability, but why? Mm-hmm. Where he want to use the ability? Ah, okay. He could kill the Blast
for the kill.
Still, there is Zephyria, and that looks like an advance for Zergrasher to the next round. He just need to up the might, play the Zephyria, and just bounce back the Osmotic Breeder, and it looks GG. So Zergrasher advanced to the next round, Zevalu going down to the loser bracket. And which match should we see next? What do you think, Uraxor?
There's a Lurifax against Red Pepper should still be ongoing.
Lurifax versus Red Pepper, okay. But my friend list is so huge, I need to find them. Okay, I'm joining to the game. We are here, Red Pepper playing Char and Lurifax playing his famous Ignatius. Ah, that's already the 8th round. Round 8. And it's not looking good for Red Pepper at the moment. There is 2 Troll on the board, there is 1 Bound Succubus on the board. High Q coming. And maybe that's enough for the clear. Yep, but there is another Bound Succubus in Lurifax B's hand. So this game should be ending the next turn. And Lurifax should win this. I don't know the standings.
No, me neither.
And some BM coming, just deploy more creature just to be sure. But it was fast and deadly. Okay, I guess we should watch the next game of Lorifax Red Pepper if they are replayed. Lorifax in this game, so I will check him. Or we can see the aggressor power, which still didn't start it.
But they're no, they're
You are lagging a little, I don't understand, sorry.
all waiting last game finish. Are the same. About 1-1. So that's the
I don't really understand you, I'm sorry. But you like a robot. Anyway, I guess I will start to see the Zagrasher or the Lurifax game. Oh, round 2 starting soon in Lurifax B and Renpepper. Okay, then we will see that. Sounds good. Until that, I will make another giveaway, but you, unfortunately, you guys, this was 10 minutes before now. So always keep eyes on the chat because there are coming some packs for you.
Okay, so the round 2 should be start. I think now we should be able to join at any minute. Any minute.
Okay. Looks like they didn't start it yet. So until that, I'm just going to give the code for those 3D because he want to give away.
Nice. Congrats.
Lurifax really like to play Ignatius. I played against him in the group stages and he played against me like 3 times Ignatius, and his Ignatius decks are really good.
It seems they are working for him.
Yeah, especially with the new bounce succubus, new, almost new bounce succubus, Ignatius can be very strong. And the game is starting, looks like. Lurifax playing at the moment Cassandra. It's some kind of spell Cassandra, I guess, because there is Zephyria, which requires 4 spell and soul power. Oh, it's the round 2. Okay, it's already soul power. He's playing Mother Namtaru. Mother Namtaru, who just got with the last patch a little nerf, but still, of course, a very good deck because of the spell skills.
Yeah. Lurifax is playing with Varding Inquisitors, which I think is really interesting to see how they will work out.
I really love to see that. My favorite card, one of my favorite card from the new expansion.
I still think it's really strong, but we will have to see.
Yeah, it's really, I guess it's really strong, but you need to use it really well. It's hard to use it because you need to know where to use it, when to use it, I mean.
You have to have really good
You need to build a good board advantage. You need to build a good situation for playing Warding Inquisitor. You need to have like 4 or 5 creatures on the board, and then Warding Inquisitor, and then Kalazar can play Arcadfrats there. That's just awesome. Also, it's very good with Sunrise, but Lurifax is playing Construction also, so he is playing Brex, I guess.
Yeah, I'm sure he is.
And he will start it. He will start the stack here. Stack is not really good against Modern Amteru because the ability is just killing stack instantly for 1 cost and 1 card.
But the stack comes for free, and Modern Amteru has to, you know, choose in between ability and increasing her attributes.
Yeah, that's why important the barracks coming early, like now.
Yes.
So it looks good for Lurifax. He is a Danish player. He is a Danish Viking. Viking, I mean, I'm sorry. My English. Ho ho. Okay, he is still thinking. I don't know what.
He seems to be thinking a lot.
He even can play Construction and Dragon Crystal if you want, but I like Construction and the Crossbowman here. I think that's better.
Yes. And he went for a power lane. It's really vulnerable to a geyser now, as it stands, though.
Yes, but killing Carl. Oh! What a relocate. That was unexpected for me. But, you know, I don't really like to play Geyser against a 1/1/1 creature and against a 3/2/6 which not dying. So that should be still good. Now
well,
it's more...
the Vanguard.
Yeah, the Vanguard.
And you want Edward Knight, so it would be a good Geyser here, I think.
Yeah, now it's good Geyser. For sure, but there isn't Geyser. So, BR Superpower need to find another solution. Spider Guard, for example, looks obvious. But he just think about where he should play it. He can play on the bottom row or above them. I guess that's the two choice.
Yeah, and it's... perhaps the barracks can get out of hand really easy. I'm not sure why Lurifax moved the Vanguard.
Yeah, I'm not sure either. I'm not sure either. I think he just wanted to save the Tide Collector. That was the reason.
Yeah, but there's still a better place. Well, he would need to move it in front of the Neophyte Leash, but that would still make more sense for me.
Yeah, maybe. Okay, another construction coming. Can be helpful.
More will be for sure. He will just play Construction and another of the Griffin Crossbowmans. That is like, 15 seconds turn.
Yeah, that looks obvious, but he also can play something like a
once you see it.
Dragon Crystal and Double Priest to heal that Vanguard. Yeah, but I also more like your choice with Crossbowman. I think that's an obvious move. The problem with that...
Then he can...
A problem with that, still the ability, for example, he can't really grow the stacks too much because of ability.
He can slow Madunamtaru down.
That's
true. He will become really dangerous. And a lot more dangerous than...
But he need to think about Geyser.
He should play the... I'm playing it now.
Yeah, he just exactly did what you said. Play the construction, play the barracks, and kill the ghoul with the crossbowman.
And next the Dragon Crystal, the Varding Inquisitor, and when another 2-drop, just to prevent Soul Power from using the Ice Meteor, which he will be able to use in 2 turns. And if he does that, I think he will win. Because then he will just get the momentum, and BR Soul Power will have no answers for it, because he's gonna rely on his spells more and more now.
Yeah, that's a really cool plan, I agree. So the Drunk Crystal, Warding Inquisitor, and another Crossbowman. For sure, looks good. And just prevent the Ice Meteor. Because that Ice Meteor, the reason why BR Soul Power not going to kill the stacks with ability, I guess. Now he need to go for the magic. Maybe he can play Soul River.
A Soul River is really ineffective against two cost creatures.
Oh, yep. But he could kill the Vanguard here. And also the stack, that was a good move, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, another.
That was a good value.
Another barracks.
He has 3 barracks in game, and he got them all out by turn 5. That is really nice.
Well, maybe I would play that barrack. But yeah, in this way, these stacks keep alive. From Vampire Knight, but what he don't know is Ice Meteor. Ice Meteor will land and deal some damage, for sure. Or maybe Frozen Wave.
Frozen Wave.
It's maybe even better because Crossbowman can't attack them. Yeah, looks like BSO Power doing that. And no, he doing the Ice Meteor. Okay.
He's saving the Frozen Wave for later. But now Lurifax has his shooter lane filled up, so he can't really play the Varding Inquisitor, which is really hurtful.
Yeah, but he's still in good standing if he's going to play Barrax and something free cost creature, for example Vanguard, he can't really play anything else.
Yeah. Starting for next turn, he can play the Fury as well.
Yeah, but next turn
he's just waiting for an opening.
Next turn, Frozen Wave coming, I guess. His board will be cleared.
Yes.
At least that looks obvious for me. Again. Maybe even BSU Power can draw first and play the ghoul after Frozen Wave, or just play the Frozen Wave and... Whoa! That's not gonna be a frozen wave here if he's using the ability.
He's holding on to it real tight. I don't know why.
Well, with this, next turn, maybe Warding Inquisitor will come.
Yeah, but Lurifax has too many shooters, I would say.
The barracks are really in bad position. That's the problem, in my opinion. I wanted to say that already.
Yeah, with this many shooters, he should really play them as melee, at least two of them.
Maybe he just drove too many shooter.
Maybe. But yeah, that means that even if Bear Soul Power played the Frozen Wave now, Lurifax would just play new creatures, he wouldn't really...
But he can only play two creatures there. Oh yeah, I don't know. Maybe a superpower decided to play a Boneyard, which is interesting. Just let Lurifax attack here. But he has a little luck, because Lurifax hasn't any melee in hand. Maybe he should play Broken Bridge on the top and replay the Watchman.
No, I would just play the Zephyria it would be 5 damage on the bottom lane, and he would deal a lot of damage this way, and then he could just bridge the Zephyria next turn and play her again, which should be enough for the win.
Yeah, that's a very nice plan. But next turn, Frozen Wave will come for sure.
Yeah. In that case, he can still bridge Zephyria, just have it safe in his hand, and then can play another more creatures. And that will make it really, really hard for Soul Power to block. Because if he knows that there's the Zephyria, well, there's not much he can do against it. So he will have to be clearing the board turn.
What about just moving the Watchman? Or not? Don't even need to move the Watchman, just play the Inquisitor and save the Zephyria for next turn. That's also a win, I guess.
No, it's better. It's the same as in the previous matchup, as you've said, like, he needs to push damage as fast as he can, and that's exactly what he is doing now.
The problem, he can lose the Zephyria here, from Ice Meteor or something like that.
That's the risk, but...
And there is already a Boneyard on the board. And look at that, his board is just cleared with Frozen Wave. So it's not a sure win. But yeah, next turn anyway, Warding Inquisitor will win the game. I guess that will be a winner card.
Oh yeah, he's not taking the Inquisitor into account at all. Because if he plays the Inquisitor now, the Zephyria will be just able to attack, correct?
Yes.
So that's 3 more damage. Yeah, there you go. Plus he can't even kill her off now with spells.
He should play first the other creature. Of course, just to give him plus... Now that Watchman didn't get a magic ward, a spell ward.
Oh, you're right.
That was a little mistake, but doesn't really matter at the moment, I guess.
Yeah. But it's a good point to make. So, BR Soul Power now has just to block. Like, maybe can use his ability. But that's still not much. Plus there's the bridge plus Zephyria for Lurifax on the next turn, which is... I don't think he can block that.
He can't.
PR Soul Power.
This looks already GG. He can't block the lane. And yes, Breed Zephyria will win for sure. Not even need because of Storm Rage on the bottom.
Yeah.
But he's going to eat. I think
more classy.
Yeah, and he already planned it in the previous turn, so.
Yeah. Oh, and Warding Inquisitor kill.
Oh, it was a nice game. And again, Cassandra win. Haven,
Cassandra rocks.
Okay. Next, I think we should play the we should see the rematch between Lurifex and BR Superpower. This was a different deck than what Zevalu played. At least I think Zevalu played without Zephyria. I don't know if Lurifex played with any spell. Oh, he played with Storm Rage. Yes, he played with Storm Rage. I saw that. Don't know. Looks strong. The construction looks strong, and it's. I hope it can save the meta somehow.
Maybe.
But players are creative and always find a way to break the meta. We saw it a lot of time.
Yeah. The game itself isn't gonna change much for weeks, probably months, so it will be other players too.
Yeah, I don't have any information, but I guess the next expansion will hit only in the around the start of the 2015 second quarter, so around March or April or something like that.
Well, it's even just some rebalancing stuff that could be made as well, and some polishing. It will be really interesting to see what they decide to go for first.
Yeah, and at least they are working on the draft mode. I don't know, it's really hard, I guess, to make a draft here, because there are so many cards, and the rarity is not really about the strength, so it can be really hard to make draft mode here, at least the balanced draft mode. What do you think? Yes?
We will have to see how they decide to do it. As VIPs, I hope that we will get to have some say in it. So hopefully it should be good. Hopefully we can help them make it really good one.
Yeah, Kimundi said to us, they will care about VIPs and they will ask them, so I hope it. The VIPs know the game very well. There are lots of very good VIP players who is really on the top, and I guess Ubisoft need to hear the VIPs' voices.
Yeah, it would be nice anyway.
But we will see.
It's the winner of this match will be advancing into tomorrow's games, because for upper brackets round 2, this is the final round for today, and then we still have the loser, the lower brackets, 2 more games to go. So there's a lot of stuff coming still, even for today. But the winners will have real short games today, so they will have time to relax and prepare for tomorrow.
Yep, and the other game is Zagrasha versus Pavel.
Mm. There is. Both of them are super strong, and both of them are really good in competitive playing, even if we haven't seen them in Paris a few weeks ago. But I think
Pavel had a very good chance. I guess if Pavel just playing in the last Gold Cup, okay, the game is starting. So Pavel, if nice. Just playing in the last Gold Cup, he should make it really easily to achieve the Paris. But he didn't even register. He was in the top 60. I guess he just hasn't time, or I don't know. He don't really want it to go come to Paris. So unfortunately, he didn't came. But he's a very good player. He won one qualifier in go to Paris, and against me. It was against me. So
remember well.
I remember how good is him. And I guess he beat me 3-0 or something like that. So it was good for him. But he didn't try it. I don't know why. Sadly he didn't try it.
Well, that is what this tournament is for, because Road to Paris was just one-time thing, but this here needs dedication and it needs skill at the same time. And so far he's doing really, really well.
Yep. So Bia Super were playing now Kalazar, and Luifex playing Ignatius again.
And it's interesting to see that Lurifax chose to play the Lurker on 3 resources over some of the 3 drops, just to block off some damage.
Yep. I don't know why. I have no idea why he played Lurker.
He is just trying to block, I guess. BR soul power is being really offensive here, using the ability to gain advantage.
And also moving away with the succubus. Yeah. He's just going to be offensive. But I guess Ignatius need to deal damages against Kalazar in early game. That's why I don't really understand that Lurker. But Lurifex playing Ignatius a lot, and he should know the matchup much more than me.
True. Oh, he even chose to let the Jaggi go.
Yep.
Well, Kalazar can just get rid of the Lurker now, even at the cost of ignoring his attributes again.
I don't think he will. I think Osmotic here is a little bit better, and playing that after that. After true. That, the Firebolt. Next turn.
True. Because Lurifax is far away from any big board clear, so Solpar BR has decided to just keep pushing his advantage. And is trying to really...
I don't know if Lurifax has any board clear.
Yeah, apart from, like, broken bridges.
Yeah, but that's just a lane. Or row.
Yeah. Yeah, it will be really interesting to see if he can make this work or not.
Okay.
Oh, Void Rift.
Void Rift. Where you see Void Rift? There is Color of the Void.
Yeah,
oh, next card. Okay,
yes.
I see now.
That can help against time jumps and maybe Arkad's Wrath, but he would have to have the advantage.
Whoa, that's a lot of bridge coming. Lurifax is really defensive. Oh. Still, the Osmotic Breeder, Firebolt and ability looks good for me now.
Yes.
Next turn he can play Spell Stealer Heretic to get back that Sioux River. or Arcade Frats, if he decided to discard that. I would discard something else, I guess.
Like a breather. Yeah, he goes for the breather.
Yeah. And it looks really good for BR Superpower.
It does.
He has board advantage, he has a better raid game, and Luriflex didn't deal any damage yet. But he's really bad as Ignatius at this point of the game.
He has been on back foot the entire game, so it will be really tough for him.
Yeah, that's already a bad situation when you need to defend with Ignatius. You want to attack and keep the pressure and so on.
Exactly.
Now maybe two Troll of Hatred coming, or not even. Color of the Void. But still, Spell Stealer Heretic can come, get back the Soul Reaver next turn, Arcade Fights if he want. Looks too good for Superpower to lose it, I guess. He can play the... I would play the Spell Stealer Heretic here to kill the Fatebender. And just deal that 3-4 damage. But looks like he will kill the Troll instead. No, he will kill the Caller of the Void with that. Oh, Fire Rain! Okay.
Well played.
That was
Now the entire board is his.
Yeah, that was the best, I guess. Void Rift coming, but it's a lose, I guess. He wanted to get something Spell Stealer Heretic from the hand. That was the only one.
Yeah. I think that gave up.
Yeah, he already gave up. He knows there is 18 HP. In Kalazad, he just can't win this game. Not even, he hasn't even board pressure.
Yeah. So will that bring us to 1-1 then?
Yes, and will be the final. The decided game. Decider game.
Yes. And as it's upper brackets, even the loser here will still get another chance in the lower brackets, so that's really good for them, I think.
Yep. Lurifex only has a chance if he discarded the Arcade Rats. Yes, and somehow just going... No, he can't. He can defend here. Oh, he can, maybe. If he discard the Arcade Rats, that can be a defend. But nope, Arcade Fights still in the hand, and BR Superpower will use it, and Spell Stealer Heretic or will finish the job, or even Osmotic Breeder.
Yeah. And Brack is Retro of 1-2-0 against my Sparrow, so he remains in game.
Okay, so this is 1-1. Yeah, Red Pepper. Red Pepper is a very good player also. If I'm seeing right, he is the only one here who was in Paris.
True.
Well, MLM vs. Smarties would be here, but he has some life-threatening, and he just couldn't play.
Yeah, he couldn't make it for today, which is really unfortunate, because it would be nice to see him play.
Yeah,
but
of course,
it didn't happen.
Always nice to see the world champion playing.
Yeah, that's true. We'll see, like, if any other tournament comes up, maybe he will be able to make it.
Yeah, he will sure.
I'm sure he will.
He's playing this game since 2012. So it's a really, like really long time. He was even in the closed beta, if I'm right. You should know it because you was in the closed beta also. I wasn't. I started at the open beta.
I've started like first or second week of open beta.
Oh, then you started when I started it.
Yeah.
At least around.
I remember just joining to see Matrix winning the first World Championships. And I was so sad because if I knew like a couple of weeks earlier, I would have been able to have a go at it as well.
I was in that tourney and I can't even remember who just beaten me. No, unfortunately, I can't remember. But I played Inferno and I got only Haven deck. You know, that was the tournament where players get a simple account, new account, everyone got a new account, and everyone got free boosters. And Matrix this just got a DA in one of the boosters.
And they won the entire tournament.
And he had a very good knowledge of the game also, so...
Yeah, yeah. Now he was already a good player back then.
Yep. And he was a big loss for this game, unfortunately. I'm still waiting, well, he's coming back.
He should be, he might. Once... Oh. It would be nice to see him back. Anyway, the Pavel against Zergrusher game is still on, and Zevalu against E-Viper game is still on, and we're waiting for Lurifox.
We should join then the Zergrusher game. Oh, it's the Zergrusher versus Pavel. Pavel playing Kalazar and Zergrusher playing Cat. Oh, what's happening? Okay, it's turn 12 already, so it's a late game. Pavel hasn't any card in hand, and let's see. Well, I think here Zergrusher just going to kill the wall board with Insect Swarm, Storm Rage Hunter will and War Elephant will survive. He will play the dive run to kill the last succubus, and that should be a game win for him if Arcad Flood's not coming. Next turn for Pavel. At least I would do that. Maybe he will find a better solution, but I don't think so. That looks... Just attack with the Harpy. Insect Swarm, attack with the Olifant and Damran. Next turn, even Shredder coming.
Oh, okay, I should be in the game now as well. Takes ages to load when it's like turn 12.
Yeah, he going what I said. It's Insect Swarm coming. Whoa! Of course, the breeder came also.
but he doesn't actually care.
Yeah, not really.
Oh, that was not a good pull.
Yeah, that's just GG.
Magic Steel.
Yeah, Magic Steel not the best against Cat, and Pavel won this game. I mean, Zergrusher has won.
Yes.
Pavel lost.
Maybe we can try the Lure if we are... No, they're still waiting.
They are still waiting. I think we should wait for them.
Yeah.
I like to see the matches from the start.
too. Plus, easier to load, it doesn't take ages. And so it's, so far it's quite nice. We've seen a good number of decks. Of course, Kalazar is the most frequent one. I think there's at least some of them in pretty much every best of three. At least some Kalazar, but at least it's not just him. So that's nice.
We saw two Cassandra already, two Haven.
Yeah.
And both deck is one. I have to say that. Great. We just didn't see any Academy yet, or we didn't see any Sanctuary. I wanna see Shalan, oh god. I hope I hope Lurifex will play Shalan next.
Do you think he would?
Maybe Spire Shalan can be that bad. Some players can do a really good job with Spire Shalan.
Nice. That sounds interesting, that's for sure. It's just too sad to don't see any Academy at all, because Academy is like so interesting and it's really nice faction with a lot of good mechanics, but Arcad Rats just kills it so badly.
Yeah. Academy is a tricky one. But yeah. maybe Nihlaloc can come, or something like Ashala Mill, or one, something Ashala Immolation. I don't know. Ashara Spirit.
Yeah, somebody. Right, somebody could try to play it just to surprise your opponent. We will see if it actually comes down to that. I think that you need to be really brave to pull that, and you need to be really sure what you're doing.
Yep.
And we are still waiting. Oh no, they're in game now, right?
Yes, I'm going to join. And this is the second game, right? Second game between Biasu Power and Lurifex B. Lurifex B is ahead with 1 point.
No, isn't it 1-1?
1-1 already? Okay, I'm sorry then. My memory is just bad.
It's right.
And it's Modern Amtaru. Oh, Lurifex playing interesting decks, he's switching deck. Biasu Power keep playing Kalazar, looks like.
Yeah, that's the same, like Zerg Rusher keeps playing his cut and all his opponents constantly swapping decks, trying to find a way to beat him.
Yeah.
There's a lot of time jumps in this game.
Yep. And what you would pick against someone who is constantly playing Kalazar? Because I don't know. I have no idea what can beat Kalazar mostly. I mean, more than 60%.
Well, Afkal has done it quite nicely in Paris, but he was a little bit lucky there as well, especially with the time jumps. So that's interesting option.
Yeah, well, Damaira can deal with it if you find Grand Purge in time.
Yeah.
That's true.
Or you would need some either. You need to discard the time jumps. That's like the key thing, isn't it? So maybe you could try some Sanctuary with Lotus Pond. But then
But Sanctuary is really weak against Arcadfrats, that's the problem.
Yeah.
And you just can't decide what you are. I would say I would pick Deleb with lots of Hall of Amnesia maybe. And Grand Purge. With 4 Hall of Amnesia and Grand Purge. I played it in lot there and it worked really well against Kalazar. You just can discard with Maniac Taskmaster with Hall of Amnesia and it's really cool.
True. But on the other hand, you have to play Inferno to beat Inferno. And you're kind of getting in this vicious circle.
Yeah. But against the lab, he need to pick something else, like a Modern Amtaru, Asha's Nightmare. That's really cool deck against the lab. Well, Lurifex. The power of Lurifex decks is really, I think it's really that lord. The healing power is really good. I lost a lot of matches because I faced against that lord, the Batman, as others said. And the war synergy of the deck is really nice with Frozen Waves, with flyers, with vampires. And also Insect Swarm is really good with vampires because you just play Insect Swarm and then the life drain really can help. It's a cool deck, but the problem against Kalazar is I guess the time jump, because Lurifex need to wait and reach the late game, and Kalazar also very strong in the late game, but he is stronger in the early and mid game in my opinion. And if Kalazar can do enough damage early on, then time jump really can be game decider.
Yeah, absolutely. That's what Lurifax needs to be really careful about. But then again, he has his own time jumps, so it's just about keeping the board until he can play them, and whoever manages to do that efficiently, I think, will win.
But the difference between the two time jumps is the creature's powers. BSU power has Juggernaut, has Osmotic Breeders, has Spellstealer Heretic, all of them is over 2 damage, but Lurifex only playing with 2 damage creatures, which is just mostly not enough. Well, we will see. Stone Shield coming, that's a nice addition, until he just drew the Removers. He really need a Frozen Wave or Ice Metal or something like that here.
Yeah. He has Insect Swarm plus Geyser, which is not 100% board clear, but it's still pretty efficient.
Yeah, especially if BSU power are going to play more creatures here.
Yeah.
Swelling Breeder.
I'm not really sure what could he play, because like anything beyond what he has on board already would be really overextending, so I don't know. He's one turn away from the Ariana. There was maybe little bit wasted. Spellstealer Heretic. I would maybe like not even play anything at all there. What do you think?
Or maybe just playing the Swelling Breeder on the backline.
Yeah.
That should protect the Osmotic Breeder also with Magic Resist. But you know, Spellstealer Heretic has also Magic Channel too, so he preparing with Time Jump also. And he
was trying to go for that.
He should know that's coming, but with that many spells it was obvious he will get something what can kill those creatures. Ariana on the Banish the Boneyard can be very effective. And Lurifox doing a great job here, even with defending, even with attacking.
Yeah, Lurifox is playing real nice, and he got in just by hair, like when M&M had to go, Lurifox took his place, and now he is a game away from making it into the final day. So that is very impressive, I think.
Yes. Well, there are time jumps, but no creature which can exploit it.
He has
a very Oriana.
Oh yeah, I love that one. I got it like early on, and I'm so proud of it. He should maybe target one of the boneyards. What do you think? The Ariana, would you save it for later, or would you get rid of some of the boneyards?
Yeah, of course. I would pick that also. I'm sure he will also. No really other choice. Alone in the dark is not really good, because even if he killing the tree, that will come back, and 4-1 damage is not worth it. For sure Ariana is the play.
Interesting.
Okay, he just banished the tree.
In a way it worked, because Lurifax doesn't have another 2-drop, but he has another 3 coming the next turn.
Yeah, but he still can attack and use the Wick of the Dead to block the Breeder next turn, for example.
Well, how do you know into when you only have one creature in graveyard, how do you know to which
that's true. That's
it would
true.
Go.
But at least a chance. I would play it still. That's 50-50. But I think first on the board, that will appear first, so maybe. I'm not sure. So it's maybe on the top.
Because I think that.
Because that was on the board first. I think that's the rule, but not sure. We should test it sometimes.
We should, yeah. Then there's the stone shield. I'm not really sure about that. He just wanted to use up all his resources. But now BR soul power can just exploit it in a way. Yeah. Now with 1 damage he destroys the stone shield, so I think it was a little bit too hasty.
And
Pavel won against Zergrusher 2-1, so Pavel is advancing into tomorrow straight up.
Pavel is already in the semi-final, that means. Well, Lurifax, no hard choice. And the town portal is really good for BR superpower. He can bounce back the Death Lord and just play town jump, I guess, but he will first draw. Of course. And he even can attack with Ariana. And not just go away, because next turn he can use the ability. I don't know why he didn't draw first. But doesn't really matter.
Spell Stealer Heretic and a foil one on top of that.
Yep, cute girl coming. Oh, he didn't. I wonder why he didn't use the ability. That's plus 2 damage, and he is closer and would be closer and closer with time jump. I also would move with the Swelling Breeder first, and that should be already on 6 HP.
Yeah, maybe he just doesn't want to throw away those cards, because all of them are really nice.
I would discard the Juggernaut.
Probably, yeah, but then if something goes wrong, you don't have any creatures as a follow-up.
Oh, but next turn is 12 resource, and he could play Spare Stealer Heretic to Sioux River and Time Jump.
That would have been deadly, right? Maybe he's really afraid of Frozen Wave or some block
Frozen
like
Wave
this.
Was, is Frozen Wave coming. Is a cool counter against Time Jump here.
Yeah, absolutely. Valu won against E-Viper, which means the tournament ends here for E-Viper, unfortunately. He's played really nice games. Maybe if you want, we could ask them for replays and you could stream the games that we couldn't cover on some other occasion, because I'm sure those are interesting games to watch as well.
Yeah, we should.
Yeah, so that's a thing to consider. I'll talk to you about that after the stream. And yes, Zevalu is advancing into the lower brackets, which we will follow as soon as this game finishes, pretty much, because it's the last one that we are waiting for now.
Well, I guess he will go for Sioux River, kill the Death Lord. Oh no, he going to Time Jump and just kill that for a... Oh, that's a win, yeah, right, it's a win.
It's just enough, yes. Ooh, and he has Alt Art Hasafa.
I also have.
That's nice. I didn't get one. I need it bad, because it's real nice art.
And this was the third game, so BSU Power advanced to the semi-final, and we'll play against...
Pavel. Tomorrow. Yeah, that game only happens tomorrow, though. I'm fairly certain it's 2-1 for BR now. Yes.
Okay, maybe then we should watch some replays, because no other games go.
No, there's lower brackets as well now.
Still?
Yeah, there's two more rounds for lower brackets today.
Ah, okay. So we should see the Zagrasher or Red Pepper. Zagrasher versus Red Pepper or Lurifax versus Zevalu. We didn't see Red Pepper yet, so...
Yeah, that's true.
I wanna see him. So, we have to wait until that.
Okay, so there are more people, and you can already start thinking as followers who is going to win tomorrow, because if you're right, you just may win the Sins of Betrayal box, which is waiting for one person, which Kimundi will distribute on Monday. So it's you just 2 days away and one correct guess away from three Sins of Betrayal box, which is pretty tempting, isn't it?
Yeah, also just think about it. You should be the last guy who just won something from Kimundi's hand, because unfortunately Kimundi is leaving us at Monday after the team stream, I guess.
Yeah. Maybe the team stream will be like the last prizes, but these will be like last competition prizes that he will give away.
Yeah, so don't forget to watch the Duel of Champions official channel. If I'm right, the team stream will start at Monday at 4 p.m.
Tuesday.
Tuesday, are you sure?
I think, didn't he say Tuesday? aren't team streams on Tuesday? I haven't seen one in ages, so I'm not sure, but I think it's Tuesdays.
Mostly they are as Tuesdays, but if I'm right, Kimundi has left us on Monday, and that's why he will stream at Monday. Okay, maybe the chat will help when and where will the stream start, so...
Yeah, the chat side. Anyway, I'm so gonna watch that one, at least a little bit of it, I have to see it. No, it's always Tuesdays, because he just puts up the epic into the pit, live, so to speak, isn't it?
Yeah, it's always on Tuesday, but I don't know at this time.
Okay.
You know, there is always team stream at Friday also, but there isn't. Okay, anyway.
There isn't.
I wonder who will, maybe, and I don't think so, unfortunately, Blue Byte will continue this streaming, team streaming, because this was the idea of Aza and Kimundi's idea, and they proposed it to the developers or to the producer, they should do it. But I hope someone from Blue Byte will come and do continue it, hopefully.
Yeah, I as well. I mean, we will have to wait a little bit. Not yet. Oh yeah, it started. Once Blue Byte sets down, I'm sure they will start.